Moving on to the next concept, heating effect of electric current. I told you 2-3 times that heat is generated. So how do we know how is heat getting generated? How much heat is getting generated is what we are going to understand now, and we are going to derive how to calculate it. First of all, why does this happen? Have you ever observed it heating? You switched on the bulb for a lot of time. After 3-4 hours, go touch the bulb, it will become a little hot. Your mother tells you, sit and study at home, I am going out and coming. Don't watch TV. What do you do? Your mom leaves, you switch on TV, you watch TV. Mother comes home, you hear her coming, immediately switch off TV and go open your book and tell, I was studying from 2 hours. But your mother can go and touch the TV and know, TV is hot, you did not study. How did she get to know? Why did it become hot is what we'll understand now. This is just to understand why. I will explain with respect to the definition later. In the previous videos, I already explained we have many atoms here. They all offer resistance. It is not easy for the charge to flow. Do you agree? It hits the nucleus, falls back, hits the nucleus and falls back. When you hit something, you lose some amount of energy. This here, when I hit this, my energy got converted to sound. Little bit heat. Keep hitting it, you'll get little heat also here. In electricity, when it collides with an atom, the energy is wasted in the form of heat. Wasted means given out. That word is called dissipated. Or that much energy is consumed. So it hits and energy is consumed. So that's given out in the form of heat. In some cases, it is also given out in the form of light. We will understand the different cases as we go ahead. So now, how do I derive this? Definition we will do a little later. How do I derive this? We know that power is the rate of doing work. We have already studied this in our lower classes. That power is itself work done by time taken, or nothing but rate of doing work. We already know it due to electricity, V is equal to W by Q. What is W? V into Q. Agreed? I'll put this V into Q here. In the place of W, I am putting V into Q. Any doubts? I hope not. It's very clear. So now, P is equal to V. I will combine this Q and T. Q by T is what? Current. We learnt it in this chapter. P is equal to V into I. This, let us call this the equation 1. We know that work is same as energy, and heat is also a form of energy itself. So from equation 1, instead of P equals W by T, can I say this is energy? Yes. If this is energy, energy is power into time. I will write it here. Look carefully. P is equal to, instead of work, I will write energy by time. Send the time there. P into T is E. So from equation 1, I can write power, we are talking about energy here, sorry. Energy is equal to power into time. Which energy are you talking about here? Heat energy, sound energy, light energy? Heat energy. So we say H. The power we got now is P equals VI. Here P is equal to VI. So I will substitute here VI. Time is nothing but T. This gives us the equation H is equal to VIT. There are different forms of this equation. I will write the other forms here itself. We know that this is the main equation. We know that V is equal to IR. Put V equals IR here. H is equal to, what is V? IR into I into T. H is equal to I square RT. H is equal to I square RT. V equals IR. What is I? V by R. In the place of I, put V by R. H is equal to, in the place of I, put V by R into T. H is equal to V square by R into T. So this is the derivation of your heat equations. So now let's define it. Look here. When the charge is trying to flow, it hits, falls, hit, falls. When it is falling back, you need to give it more energy to go front. Do you agree? It's falling every time, you got to give it more energy to go front. This energy, who is giving it? The battery or the source. Battery is itself your source. So the energy supplied by the source. So when it falls back like this, battery has enough energy. It is giving, it's converting the chemical reactions, chemical energy into electric, and it's giving it, it's pushing it. Come on, go, go. So the energy supplied by the source, by the battery, in maintaining, it is only maintaining the flow of current. If there's no battery, it'll hit, fall and stop. So the energy supplied by the source in maintaining the flow of current in an electric circuit is itself called electric energy. Now, if the circuit has some resistance, that means that is causing the collisions, it will hit, hit and fall. So some energy is getting wasted or dissipated. It is dissipated in the form of heat. Agreed? So what is happening? The circuit has some resistance and the energy in it is getting dissipated in the form of heat. This concept is itself called heating effect of electric current. Please refer the notes for in detailed explanation of what I just told. It's there in words in the notes section. So every circuit has some resistance and the energy gets dissipated in the form of heat. This is called heating effect of electric current. The SI unit of heat energy or any energy or work is what? Joule. So the SI unit is also joule. Symbol of joule is J. One joule definition. We know that heat is power into time now. We derived it. We saw how it came. Now, when heat is 1, power is 1 and time is 1. This is joule, watt, second. 1 is equal to 1 into 1. Agreed? Power is measured in watt. We will study in detail about power next. For now, just know power is measured in watt. So, how do we define this? If a device uses energy at the rate of 1 watt, energy at the rate or work at the rate is nothing but power. Please note, energy at the rate or work at the rate is nothing but power. So if a device uses power of 1 watt, power of 1 watt, then the energy consumed in 1 second is 1 joule. Instead of power, they've written energy at the rate. You can also use the word power, no problem. If a device uses power of 1 watt, then the energy consumed in 1 second is 1 joule. This is the definition of 1 joule. Joule's law of heating. The heat generated in a resistor is directly proportional to the square of the current flowing through that resistor. Joule's law, it also said, heat is directly proportional to the resistance through which the current is flowing. Heat is directly proportional to the time for which the current is flowing through the resistor. This was Joule's law. He told three statements. Combining 1, 2, and 3. You get H is directly proportional to I square RT. Removing proportionality sign and putting a constant, KI square RT, where K is a constant. But they have found that K is equal to 1. So what happens? H is equal to 1 into I square RT. We have already derived it normally. You saw, we got H equals I square RT. This H equals I square RT is also known as Joule's law. If they ask you what is Joule's law, you have to write all this in words. It is clearly given in the textbook. It is also given it in the notes section. Please follow it. We know that the unit of energy is Joule, but in our day-to-day life, we also have few other units of energy that we use regularly. Let us see what they are. First of all, what was heat? Power into time. Correct? So first one, joule. 1 joule is 1 watt into 1 second. All of you agree? 1 joule is 1 watt second. Same thing. Okay. The next unit that we have is called watt hour or watt hour. So 1 watt hour can be written as 1 watt into 1 hour. Any doubt? Power into time, it's energy. So this is an energy unit. 1 watt, convert the hour to minutes into 60 minutes. Convert it to seconds into 60 seconds. You are left with 3600 watt seconds. Watt seconds is nothing but joules. So 1 watt hour is 3600 joules. Going to the next kind of unit that we have, kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour, K-I-L-O, watt hour. 1 kilowatt hour can be written as 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. Kilo means 1000, 10 power 3. 1000 watt, 1 hour is 3600 seconds. This is 36 followed by 5 zeros. Watt second. I told you we have to represent standard notation. So the decimal is here. Shifted by 6 places. First non-zero digit means the decimal has to now come here. So shifted by 6 places. So this becomes 3.6 into 10 power 6. Watt seconds is nothing but joule. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 into 10 power 6 joules. Many times they ask you this for 1 or 2 marks. You should be able to derive it. This kilowatt hour is also known as the commercial unit of energy. This is also known as the commercial unit of energy. Why? In our day-to-day life, we don't use 30 joules, 40 joules. Just by lifting this pen, I'm probably using 10 joules. So much energy we use in our house for electricity. It is very, very large. So kilowatt hour is a large quantity of energy. So we use this in our house. So if you take the electricity bill and see, your bill will be in something known as KWH, kilowatt hour. Or it will say you have used 1000 units of energy, 100 units of energy. Unit means they are referring to kilowatt hour. It is called the commercial unit of energy. Our electricity bills come in kilowatt hour form. So let us see a few applications of heating effect of electric current. Where do we see that we use electricity to heat a device? You want to iron your clothes. What do? You go and light fire. You go and switch on electric iron. You switch on electricity and you're getting heat. So it is an application of heating effect of electric current. Geyser. In your house today, now we have so many electric geysers. We no longer use wood to light fire and heat the water. Correct? So, geyser also is a heating effect of electric current. In any form where you switch on the current and you get heat, that is only application of heating effect of electric current. So, geyser. Toaster is also a heating effect of electric current. Electric bulb. How is the next question? Now, an electric bulb, all of you have seen, has a filament here. Filament means through which electricity flows. That's called the filament of the bulb. There's a glass chamber here and it is filled with nitrogen gas. Why? I will explain a little later. So now this is called the filament of the bulb. That's the main thing from which current is flowing. This filament of the bulb, this thing you can see here, is made of tungsten. Why? Tungsten as a metal has high resistance. So what happens when the current flows? That because of high resistance, it generates more heat. See, why? H is equal to I square RT. What did Joule's law tell you? H is directly proportional to R. More the resistance, more the heat generated. So this tungsten metal has more heat, more resistance. So it generates more heat. It keeps generating more heat and the bulb becomes hot. Now this filament becomes hot. Tungsten is a metal. Some metals at high temperatures emit light. Have you all seen iron? When you keep heating it at a very high temperature in metal industries, it becomes reddish. You can see it on any YouTube video. That's why it's called red hot iron. You must have heard this phrase or this term, red hot iron. Is iron red color? No. When you keep heating the iron at very, very high temperatures, it starts giving red color light. Just like that, tungsten, as you keep heating it, as the temperature rises, what happens? It begins to emit light at high temperatures. This starts to emit light and we see the bulb glowing. So what is happening here? Tungsten has high resistance. More heat is generated. At high temperatures, it emits light. Now another point is, if I keep heating it too much, at one point my metal might melt. So if it melts off, if I heat something now it melts off, it will melt off. Imagine this melting off and breaking. You don't want it to melt and break. So you want the metal to have high melting point, but meaning don't melt easily. If you want to melt, melt at very high temperatures. So tungsten is also used because it has high melting point. Next question that can be asked is, why are electric bulbs filled with nitrogen gas? Metals oxidize easily, especially at high temperatures, which is why we fill it with nitrogen gas, so that we don't allow oxidation to happen. No oxidizing. So what do? We fill it with nitrogen gas to avoid oxidation. Next concept, electric power. See, power and heat, power and work, all are very, very similar. Only difference is, when you do work with respect to time, it becomes power. Meaning what? For example, there is a big bag over here. We have some 9 bags here. I have to take one bag and keep it there, one bag and keep it there continuously. To move one bag, you need, let us say, 2 joules of energy. So to move all the 9 bags, you need 18 joules of energy. Do you agree? Yes. I am Nimisha and I can do this work in 3 minutes or 3 seconds. I can do this work in 3 seconds. You, the student, you also, obviously, same energy. Whoever lifts the bag, you need same energy to lift it. You cannot give same energy, but that much energy is needed. 18 joules. But you will do the work faster than me. You're stronger than me. You do it in 2 seconds. Now tell me, who has more power? Me or you? You do the same work in 2 seconds. I take 3 seconds. Who has more power? You. How? Mathematically, 18 by 2 is 9. Here 18 by 3 is 6. This is itself your power. When you take energy with respect to time, it is power. See, it's almost the same thing. The only difference is, when you talk about power, you're bringing time into the picture. So don't get very confused. But know that power, work, energy, all are related. Power is just considering time also into the picture. So the derivation is just like how we did it for heat in the previous section. Power is defined as the rate of doing work. We already know this. But we know that V is equal to W by Q. What is W? V into Q. Substitute it here. P is equal to V into Q by T. I take this Q by T and I make it I. Because we already know I is equal to Q by T. P is equal to V into I, first formula. So we have P is equal to V into I. Now using Ohm's law, V equals IR, in the place of V, if I put IR, what do I get? Power is IR into I. P is equal to I square R, second formula. We are using Ohm's law here. You have to write it in words, using Ohm's law, V equals IR. V equals IR means I equals V by R. In the place of I, put V by R. Power is equal to V into V by R. Power is equal to V square by R. So you have the 3 formulas of power. Electric power's definition now, let's define it. See, why should we define it? We all know power is equal to rate of doing work. Agreed, this is a valid definition in physics, but this year we are dealing with electricity. So let us now define power with respect to electricity. Instead of work, can I write it as electric energy? or heat energy or just energy? Yes. So can I say this is rate of energy? Yes. Yes. Therefore, the rate at which electric energy is dissipated or consumed, meaning the energy is going away or you're using it or absorbing it, that means used. Dissipated or consumed means used. So the rate at which means 1 by T. Energy is dissipated or consumed where? On our hand? No. In an electric circuit is called electric power. We're just defining with respect to electricity. Same thing. Okay. SI unit is watt. The symbol of watt is W. The symbol of power is P, variable. Meaning, if I say power is 5 watts, I write it like this. Power is 5 watts. Example that is. There are a few other units of power that we commonly use. 1 kilowatt. Kilowatt means 10 power 3 or 1000 watts. 1 mega. Mega means 10 power 6. We have done this in the previous section. You should know it by now. What is kilo? What is mega? So these are the other commonly used units of power. 1 watt definition. Now how do you define 1 watt or define the unit of power? See here. Power is equal to V into I. It's electric power, so you have to define with respect to electricity. 1 watt. 1 is equal to 1 into 1. 1 watt is 1 volt into 1 ampere. That means this much power is consumed when? When current is 1 ampere and potential is 1 volt. You can tell it in your own words. That when the current flowing through the circuit is 1 ampere, when the potential difference applied across it is 1 volt, then the power is said to be 1 watt. You can put it in your own words. This is a textbook definition specifically. So 1 watt is the power consumed by whom? By a device that carries 1 ampere of current when it is operated at a potential difference of 1 volt. This is only put into words. You can put it in simpler words in your own terms. No problem. So how do we remember so many heat and power formulas? I'm too confused. Are you confused? Yes. So let us make an easy technique to remember this. You have to remember only one formula. Which one? P is equal to VI. Always remember this. Other formulas you can do it on the spot. See, if I put V equals IR here, IR into I, I square R. In the place of I, V equals IR. So in the place of I, put V by R. P is equal to V square by R. Now, we know that power is equal to energy by time. What is energy? Power into time. So, I am going to use this and get all the heat formula. See, power into time. Power into time. Power into time. It will give me heat. So I have now heat, first formula, power into time, VI, put the time, T, I square R, T, V square by R, T. This is an easy technique to remember all six formulas just by knowing one. Example 12.10. An electric iron consumes energy at a rate of 840 watts when heating in at the maximum rate. What does this mean? Maximum rate, minimum rate? Continuing question. And 360 watts when the heating effect is minimum. What is the meaning of this? When you use an electric iron, have you all seen? There is one screw kind knob here. If you turn it maximum, it will become very hot. If you turn it minimum, it becomes less hot. That means more you are turning it, more heat, more power. Less you are turning it, less heat, less power. So you have seen minimum rate, maximum rate will be written there. MIN, minimum. MAX, maximum. They are talking about the two different cases here. So they are saying maximum rate. When it is at maximum rate, the power consumed is 840 watt. And in minimum rate, the power consumed is how much? 360 watt. Is 360 watt. The voltage is 220 volts. So, when you use your electric iron or the plug in your house, every time, everywhere you always get 220 volts. So here also it is 220 volts. Here also it is 220 volts. Continuing the question, what are the current and resistances in each case? Your PV or PV, you know three formulas. What are the formulas that you know? P equals VI, P equals I square R, P equals V square by R. You can use any formula and get the answer. So I want current first. So which one will I use? I have P and V, first formula. So I will use P equals VI, substitute P, substitute V, get I. So what is this? 840 is equal to 220 into I. What is I? 840 by 220. All of you know how to do it. For R, you have P, you have V. You want to find R. How to find R? P is equal to V square by R. So what is this? What is P? 840 is equal to 220 into 220 by R. Solve it and find the value of R. So when you come here, similarly, P equals VI. So what is P? 360 is equal to 220 into I. I is 360 by 220. P is equal to V square by R. What is P? 360 is equal to 220 into 220 by R. Find the value of I, find the value of R. You will get the answers like this. Please see. These should be your answers. Now 1 minute. The question that might arise in your mind is, ma'am, you said if device is not changing, resistance is not changing. Do you remember? If device is not changing, resistance is not changing. Then how is the resistance changing here? If device is not changing, resistance is not changing. Ma'am, here I didn't change my electric iron. Why did the resistance values change? So now, remember one thing. Resistance remains same as long as temperature is same. In an electric iron, when you are heating it and cooling it, what is happening? You are changing the temperature, which means resistance will not be the same. You have to be very, very careful in understanding your electricity questions to understand whether the resistance is constant and whether you can use that as a condition. Example 12.11. 100 joules of heat. Heat given is 100. Are produced each second. Each second means 1 second. In a 4 ohm resistance. Resistance given is 4 ohm. Find the potential difference across the resistor. Find V. Which formula to use? We all know the four formulas that we have. Three formulas. H equals VIT. H equals I square RT. H equals V square by RT. See what you have and see what you want. HT and R is given. We have HT and R. That means option 2 or 3. You want I or V? V. So option 3. So we will take the third one and we will use this. So what happens now? H is what? 100 is equal to V square divided by R. 4 into T is 1. Send the 4 this side. V square is equal to 400. What is V? Plus or minus root 400. Ignore the negative sign because potential we are taking here as positive. So it is 20 volts. Your answer is 20 volts. Page 218, question 1. Why does the cord of an electric heater not glow while the heating element does? See, this is an electric heater. You must have seen this in electric gases. If you have not seen it, this is how it looks. This is the wire connected to the gas. You just put it to the electric supply and switch it on. This is called the cord, meaning the wire through which the current is flowing. This is the cord and this is the electric heater. This electric heater, can you see it's glowing? It's becoming orangish, red? Yes. But can you see the cord glowing? Will the cord glow? No. Now you will say, ma'am, we put plastic, how will it glow, ma'am? Remove the plastic and see, it will still not glow. Why? Because the cord is made up of pure metal such as copper or aluminium. The electric coil or heater here is made up of alloy. Pure metal means less resistance. Less resistance means less heat energy is generated or less heat energy is dissipated. Alloy. So alloy means more resistance, or I can say more heat. When does something glow in this chapter due to heating? Only when the heat is more. So this will glow because more heat is generated, more temperature is there. This will not glow. So how will you define this? An electric heater is made up of an alloy. Alloy has more resistance than a pure metal. Hence more heat is generated and it begins to glow. Whereas the cord is made up of a pure metal which has less resistance. Thus less heat is generated and the cord does not glow. Compute means calculate. Compute the heat generated while transferring 96,000 coulomb. Q is equal to 96,000 coulomb. 96,000 coulomb of charge in 1 hour. Time given is 1 hour. Through a potential difference of 50 volts. They are asking you to find heat. Heat and work done the same. In this question, there are many ways to do it. What some people do is, first we'll find Q by T, find I, then go and apply one of the heat formula. In one step, very simple how to get the answer here is, V is equal to 50, H, Q is given as 96,000. H is equal to 50 into 96,000. 5 into 96, 480 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 zeros are there, 10 power 4. Put the decimal after the first non-zero digit. So the answer is 4.8 into 10 power 6 joules. An electric iron of resistance 20 ohms. Resistance given is 20 ohms. Takes a current of 5 amperes. Calculate the heat developed in 30 seconds. Use one of the heat formulas, you know, you have I, R and T. H is equal to I square R T. I square, 5 square R, 20 T, 30. 25 into 2 3s are 6, so this is 600. 25 into 6, how much? 150. There are two zeros, put it. 15,000 joules. You can leave it here or you can also write it as 1.5 into 10 power 4 joules. Anything is okay. So, now next topic, fuse. You must have heard cases where, oh, the fuse is tripped, go change it. The fuse is spoiled, go change it. What is this fuse? See, all of you all have refrigerators. You all have seen refrigerators. Fridge. You have seen a fridge? Yes. Minimum one fridge is 12,000 rupees. Do you all agree? Minimum. If you go buy a fridge, you will pay 12,000 rupees. So in your house, there's 220 volt supply coming. And the fridge is running. Fridge needs 7 amperes of current to work. Think that the current here is 7 amperes. Now there is some fault on the road, street where they are supplying the current, electric pole, something is happening and the current now entering your house is, let's say, 10 amperes. Fridge can tolerate only 7 amperes. Okay, by mistake if it becomes 7.5, okay. But you are making it 10 amperes. More the current, more the heat generated because H is directly proportional to I square. So much heat, your fridge might get burnt. So if you make it 10 amperes, so much current is coming here and the fridge is burnt and the fridge is spoiled. Gone, 12,000 rupees. So now what do? We have something called as a fuse. What does a fuse do? It is only 10 to 15, maximum 20 rupees. We take the fuse and put it here. It's made like this. It looks like this in reality. This is made from either a porcelain or a ceramic. They are insulators, case. And there's a wire inside. This wire is a good wire that can conduct electricity. It's made of usually an alloy of copper or some metal, but it's a good conductor of electricity. What happens now is, the fuse is also designed in such a way that this wire can also tolerate maximum 7 amperes. You make it 7.1, he'll say okay. 7.2, he'll start heating up. When you increase it even more, let's say you make it 8 amperes also, not even 10, even up to 8 amperes, what happens? This wire will melt. This wire will melt. Why? Because it starts heating up. Because of the heating effect, this wire melts. And now this circuit is broken. This circuit is broken. Will the current reach the fridge? No. Fridge is saved. Fuse is gone. Fuse is 20 rupees. 20 rupees, I'll buy another one. 12,000 rupees, I can't buy tomorrow. So your fuse saves your fridge. So what is this fuse? This fuse is a safety device used to protect your appliance. How does it work? It has a wire inside that melts when the current increases. That means my safety level is 7 ampere for this circuit. If you increase the current more than that, the wire will melt. If it melts, the circuit breaks and then no current flows. So your device is saved. So what does this do? It is made up of a wire that melts when the safety level of current is increased. When the current increases the safety level and it breaks the circuit. This is enclosed in a ceramic or porcelain case usually. That those are nothing but insulators. So what are the properties of a fuse wire? How do they make this wire? This fuse wire, what is its property? It has little higher resistance than the other wire, meaning, see, we don't want all these wires also to heat. Do we want these wires also to heat? If these wires also heat, all of these will keep melting. Then you have to change the full wiring of your house. No, no, no. We just want this wire to melt. If you want this part of the wire to melt, this one should have little higher resistance than this wire. Agreed? So it has higher resistance than the other wire. So in general, it has high resistance. You want it to melt easily. 7 amperes means 7 amperes. If it's increasing, you want it to start melting. So it has a low melting point. You don't want it to wait for the heat to generate. As heat is generating, start melting. So it has low melting point. Two points, it has high resistance and low melting point. So the fuse is designed based on current, correct? Because H is directly proportional to I square. As the current increases, heat is generated and the wire melts. So it is mainly based on current. So that's why fuses have current rating. When you go to buy a fuse from an electric shop, you tell him, sir, give me a fuse of 3 amperes. Sir, give me a fuse of 5 amperes. So you talk about it in terms of current. Therefore, the rating of the fuse is given in terms of current for domestic purposes. In general, we have 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere and 10 ampere fuses. There are many different types. These are generally what is used. I have a question for you. What is the principle of the fuse? On what principle, on what concept is the fuse running? It is running on the heating effect of electric current. The principle used in fuse is heating effect of electric current. Previous section we learned what is a fuse, and we also learned that a fuse is bought, when you go to buy a fuse, you buy it using current rating. That means the specification given about a fuse is current rating. Depending on the current value flowing through the device, we decide which fuse we need to put. Coming to this question, please note this question because it's not a separate question in a textbook. It's a part of the theory. Please note it. An electric iron consumes 1 kilowatt power. 1 kilowatt power. Kilo means what? 10 power 3. 10 power 3 watt. 1 kilowatt power when operated at 220 volts. Determine the fuse rating to be used. Fuse rating means what? Fuse rating means current. So, we know that P is equal to V into I. 10 power 3 is nothing but 1000. V is 220 into I. What is I? 1000 by 220. Divide it and see what you get. You will find that this value is equal to 4.54 amperes. We saw that the normal ratings of a fuse is 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, etc. So, if you had to decide 4.54 ampere, will you exactly buy a fuse with 4.54 ampere? No, because little current rise is okay. It might happen due to different reasons. It might happen even due to temperature rise or fall. So, little current rise, my device can tolerate. It won't get spoiled. So, up to 4.54 is good. That is the safety level. 4.56, 4.57, okay. 4.7, okay. 4.8, okay. 4.9, little problem. 5 may become too problematic. So, we go up to 5, and anything above 5, my device might get spoiled. So, we just round off this number and we can say, therefore, a fuse rating of 5 amperes is used. Please note, we round it off and a fuse rating of 5 amperes is used. Example 12.12. An electric bulb is connected to a 220 volt generator. Voltage given is 220 volts. The current is 0.50 amperes. What is the power of the bulb? They have asked for power. We all know that P is equal to V into I. 220 into 0.5. All of you multiply. Easy. 110 watt. Very simple problem. That's it. Before we try the next problem, just take this down. Steps for problems on energy. In a few energy questions, they will ask you calculate the total energy and calculate what is the cost. Meaning, like for example, when electric bill comes home, you pay money to clear the bill. So that time you know the energy, it's multiplied by cost and you get the answer. How do we do it? First you find energy consumed in one day. Then in the second part, find energy consumed for given number of days. If they are telling 30 days, you find energy for 30 days. How? If you know energy consumed in one day, let's say 15 joules. Then what will be energy consumed in 30 days? 15 into 30. Every day I'm taking 15 joules. 30 days, 15 into 30, 450 joules. Total cost of energy. What is total cost always? For example, if I am buying 1 liter milk for 5 rupees. If I am buying, let's say 7 liters milk, how much rupees? 7 into 5. 7 liters, 7 is the quantity, or the 7 is the quantity and 5 rupees is the cost for one quantity. That's how we got total cost is energy. How much is the total energy into cost for per unit. Per unit means 1 joule of energy or 1 kilowatt hour of energy. Usually for such questions when they talk about money, with respect to energy questions, they will always expect the answer in kilowatt hour. Why? Rewind back and understand what we learned with kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of energy. The bills coming in our house are all in kilowatt hour. So what do we do first? First find the energy in one day, then for the given number of days, then just multiply that energy into the given cost in the question. You get the total cost of the energy. Example 12.13. An electric refrigerator rated 400 watts. The power given is 400 watts. Operates 8 hours per day. What is the cost of the energy to operate it for 30 days at rupees 3 per kilowatt hour? They're talking about energy in kilowatt hour. They've given time for one day. In one day, first, always first point in one day. Next you do for given number of days. So first of all, do you know energy? No, you know power. You have to find energy. In one day, how much time is the electric refrigerator used for? 8 hours per day. So I can say in one day it is used for 8 hours. So what is the energy? Power is equal to energy by time. What is energy? power into time. Power is 400 into time 8. 4 8s are 32. 0 0. But this is in watt and this is in hour. Please observe. So this is in watt and this is in hour. So what will be my answer here? Watt hour. By mistake also do not write joules. Why? To get it in joules, answer should be in watt and second. Did I convert it? No. Why not? Is it wrong? No, because we finally want kilowatt hour. So you can keep it in whatever, later make it kilo. You can write HR or H, anything. H is fine. Okay. So now what do we do next? This is in one day. What's the next step? In 30 days. So in 30 days, what is energy? One day it is 3200. In 30 days, 3200 into 30. 32 into 3, 96. 000 watt hour. These three zeros are here. If I make this move back, 96 into 10 power 3 watt hour. 10 power 3 is nothing but kilo. So I can write this as kilo watt hour. Please, if you don't understand this, rewind the video and rewatch it. Now, you have in 30 days we have the total energy. So now, can I find the total cost? Easy, because I already know the energy now. I know the total energy. Just multiply with the given cost. 96 kilowatt hour, 3 rupees for 1 kilowatt hour. So 96 into 3, 288. Rupees 288 is the total cost. Page number 220, first question. What determines the rate at which energy is delivered by current? Please understand this carefully. Whenever I told you rate at which energy, rate of energy comes, what should we do? It is power. We have already come across this in the previous section. Rate at which energy is nothing but power. So they are asking what determines, which quantity determines rate at which energy? Answer is already here, power. Which power are we talking about? The one delivered by current? Or which power are we talking about? Are we talking about work power, physical power? So here, since it's delivered by current, we are talking about electric power. That's your answer. Next question. An electric motor takes 5 amperes. 5 amperes means what? Current. From a 220 volt line. 220 volt means potential. Determine the power of the motor. So you have to determine the power of the motor and the energy consumed in 2 hours. Time given is 2 hours. Easy question. You have I, you have V. Can we find P? Yes. P is equal to V into I. What is V? 220. What is I? 5. Multiply 220 into 5. How much do we get? 1100 watt. Next, energy. See, in energy you have to be very careful with time. If the time is in hour, you are allowed to keep it in hour because it is a common unit. Watt hour, kilowatt hour. Don't waste time converting to joules with respect to energy questions. But let us say you are finding the energy and then using that energy somewhere else. Then you have to convert it into joules. No keeping it in watt hour. Understanding? So your final answer of energy is allowed to be in watt hour or kilowatt hour. Energy over here, you can use directly power into time or you can use VIT, anything. Power into time is easier, so I will use power into time. You can also use energy is VIT. But again, you have to multiply VI. VI is nothing but power. So I will be using this formula. Now you can do that, no problem. What is the power? 1100 watt. Time? 2 hours. See, for energy question, it's better to write the unit so you won't miss out on joules or watt hour or kilowatt hour. Multiply these two. 2200 watt hour. This is my energy. This is my power. So this brings us to the end of the chapter. Please refer the NCERT exercise solution questions. It is very important. There are few different problems. You need to do it to understand better. And you also have to go through the practice test to get a better grip on the subject. Thank you.